This video tutorial I will explain how to get all employee records using layered architecture and JDBC template in Spring Boot. Here you can see three different layers: controller layer, service layer and repository layer. Here you can see Postman client, which sends get all employees request to the controller. Then request goes to the service layer. Then it goes to the repository layer, and repository layer get all employees records from employee table in the database, and finally the get all employees response goes back to the client. For controller layer, we have defined employee service controller class annotated with REST controller. For service layer, we have defined employee service symbol class annotated with service. For repository layer, we have defined employee repository class annotated with repository. Here you can see employee table and it has three records. We will see how to get all these three records. Here you can see Spring Boot application with folder structure. And here you can see pom.xml. I have included the dependencies of web, JDBC, MySQL connector. Here you can see application.properties file. In this file, I have defined driver class name, URL of the MySQL database, and username and password of the MySQL database. Using this information, the Spring Boot application makes connection to the MySQL database. Here I have defined the class employee. It has four properties: ID, name, age and salary, and getter and setter methods for these four properties. And here I have overridden toString method. Here I have defined the class employee repository, which is repository class, and here I have defined JDBC template, and I have put auto void annotation. So when Spring Boot application starts, it creates a JDBC template object and inject here. Here I have defined the method get employees. This method returns a list of employee object. In this method, I am calling a query method of JDBC template object and passing the SQL. The SQL is select star from employee table and the employee row mapper object. Here I have defined the class employee row mapper, which implements row mapper interface and provide implementation of map row method. In this method, we are mapping result set output to the employee object. This method will be called when query method of JDBC template is executed. Here I have defined the interface employee service, and it has get employees method. This method is abstract method. Here I have defined the class employee service simple, which is a service class, and it implements employee service interface and provide implementation of get employees method. From this method, we are calling get employees method of employee repository object. Here I have defined a class employee service controller, which is REST controller, and here I have defined the method get employees. To call this method, we have to send request to this path, and method should be get. In this method, we are calling get employees method of employee service object, and this method returns list of employee objects, and that list of employee object is written back to the caller. Here I have defined a class application, which is Spring Boot application. I am starting this Spring Boot application in debug mode. Spring Boot application is started in 8080 port. Next, using Postman client, I am going to send request to get all the employee records from the employee table. And here is the URL and method is get. And I am sending the request. And request reached to the controller. And request goes to the service layer. Then the request goes to the repository layer. There are three employee records are there. So this method is executed three times. And we got employee list, and this list will be written back to the client. And here you can see we got three employee objects in JSON format. You can get Java source code link for each video in the description section of the video. Here you can see the description section. Click on show more. And here you can see the Java source code links. Click on these links to get the Java source code.